Want to learn how to create consistent characters with AI for self-publishing children's books without paying for expensive tools? In today's video, I will show you how to do it completely free using Gemini 2.0 inside Google AI Studio. Previously, I made a tutorial showing how to create consistent characters with Midjourney AI. Now, Midjourney is a great tool, but it's a paid service. So if you are looking for a free alternative to create consistent character illustrations, Gemini 2.0 can be a great option. In this video, I will also compare the results from Gemini and Midjourney side by side so you can decide which one fits your project better. Let's dive in. As I said previously, I made a video about how to create consistent characters in Midjourney using the Midjourney character reference feature, ChatGPT, and Canva. In that video, I used the ChatGPT model GPT 3.5, which was the latest version at that time, to craft a short children's story aimed at kids aged 4 to 6. I will skip over the full story creation process quickly in this video. If you want more details about how I structured everything, feel free to check out my previous video. But just to give you a quick summary, since working on a page-by-page basis really helps when you create the artwork later with AI tools, I asked ChatGPT to create a detailed outline showing what would appear on each page of the children's book. After that, ChatGPT provided me with a full story outline. Then, I asked ChatGPT to write the image prompts for each illustration separately. In this video, I will use the exact same prompts so that we can fairly compare the results between Midjourney and Gemini, especially focusing on character consistency. First, go to aistudio.google.com and log in with your Google account. On the right side of the screen, under the Run Settings panel, you will see a section called About Gemini Models. Today, we will be using Gemini 2.0 Flash Image Generation Experimental. Currently, this model is completely free to use, which makes it a great option if you are just starting out or looking for an alternative to paid tools like Midjourney. So this was the character image I created in Midjourney in my last video. His name is Alex, and here's the prompt I used to generate this image. Now I'm going to upload this image into Gemini and write the exact same prompt that I used in Midjourney. You can start your prompt with something like, use this image as a character reference, but honestly, based on my previous tests, it's not even necessary for Gemini to understand and match the character well. So, let's just copy our first prompt, which is dribbling his basketball down the sidewalk, paste it in, and click run. Okay, Gemini is generating the image now. It looks like, since the background wasn't indicated in the original prompt, Gemini considered it as a plain white background, just like in the original character image. As you can see, the character consistency looks quite good, but honestly, I don't like the white background, so I'm going to try again. To do that, you can click the three dots for more options on the right edge of the prompt box. From there, you can delete the prompt and update it to indicate a background. But since I want to use the exact same prompts I used in the previous video, I'm just going to click rerun this turn right here. Okay, this time it looks very good. If you check the details, the character is consistent and the background looks better for the scene. So I'm going to download this image by clicking here. Now, let's move on to the second prompt. This time the prompt is, he's practicing his basketball dribbling skills in an idyllic park setting. Alright, let's run it and see what happens. Okay, it seems we didn't get a good result here. As you can see, the image is distorted, not what we want. So I will click on more options, delete this image, and rerun the prompt. Alright, the character looks better now, but if you notice, my prompt specifically asks for him to be practicing his basketball skills, and it doesn't really show that clearly here. So I will run the prompt again. Okay, this time the scene and the character are more in line with the prompt, but if you look carefully, it's basically the same pose as the previous image, just with a different background. When this happens, I prefer to delete everything and start fresh. Because it seems like Gemini started to use the second image as a new reference instead of sticking to the original character image. So, I will delete all the images and prompts, keep only my original character image uploaded, and retry the same prompt. One thing to remind you, I couldn't find a way to save the entire chat session in Gemini. Maybe it's because of my account settings, or maybe because it's still an experimental version. Either way, if you want to keep your work, make sure to manually download the images and copy any important prompts or text before deleting anything. Alright, this time, as you can see, we have a much better result. So I will download this image too. Let's continue with the next prompt. He is watching the older kids playing basketball on the nearby court, his eyes wide with excitement. Again, I will try to continue the chat like before. If I don't get what I want, I will restart the chat just like we did. Okay, same thing happened again. It just changed the background, but it's clearly using the previous image as a reference. Sometimes Gemini gives better results without doing this, but today it's being a bit stubborn. So to save time, I will just delete all and start from the beginning again. Alright, this is not a bad result, but I still want to rerun it to see if we can get something even better. Okay, this one matches the scene better and it gives a pretty consistent backside view of the character. It's not perfect, but definitely good enough for a children's book illustration. I think by now you got the idea. I basically followed the same steps to generate images for each scene. Most of the time, I got better results when I restart the chat from the beginning. So if you don't get the results you want right away, I recommend you do the same. It really makes a difference. Alright, now that we have a good set of images generated with Gemini, let's move on to the fun parts. I'm going to show you a side-by-side comparison of the images we created with Midjourney versus the new ones we just made with Gemini. This way you can really see the difference in style, quality, and most importantly character consistency, and decide which one fits better for your project.
Dribbling his basketball down the sidewalk. Practicing his basketball dribbling skills in an idyllic park. Watching the older kids playing basketball on the nearby court. Hesitating at the edge of the court in an idyllic park, his basketball clutched in his hands. Side view of Alex walking confidently toward a group of older kids in an idyllic park, holding a basketball under his arm. Seen from the side, Alex is looking up, talking with older and taller kids in an idyllic park. Alex dribbling past offenders, playing basketball with the older kids in an idyllic park. Alex is jumping and celebrating after scoring a goal in the basketball hoop in an idyllic park. Alex walking home down the sidewalk, holding a basketball with his two hands, with a smile on his face and a bounce in his step, feeling proud and accomplished. Alex sleeps soundly in his bed, eyes closed, with his basketball resting by his side.
To sum up, I think Gemini 2.0 does a really good job at creating consistent characters. It's fast, it's free, and honestly it's pretty exciting when you think about using it for different projects. By the way, I made a video earlier about how I created a book trailer using the Midjourney images from this same story, and I used Clink AI for that. If you are interested, feel free to check that out too. Clink AI has gotten way better since I made that video, so maybe I will make a new updated tutorial. If you want to see that, let me know in the comments. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.